How do you scuba dive without certifications or tanks?
We're afraid they already smell like electrical fire. Got it.
Damn, this is gonna work.
What's up, legendaries? Today, we're gonna try to build something that I've wanted to build for a long time. Something I wanted to do, something I wanna do with the family, but no real way to do it. We wanna go scuba diving. The problem is, how do you scuba dive without certifications or tank? Which certifications and tank for three people to dive 5-10 feet, to hunt for shark's teeth, to hunt for arrowheads, to look for shells and things. There's no way. For a family of three, it's just not cost effective, especially in this economy. So what do? Figure out ways to change it. This is Blue. The company is BLU3. Realistically, it's a great company. I've talked to them, I asked them questions, and they are real responsive, and it's a great product. Their lowest end is $1,200, $1,200, $1,300. And it's a really great solution for one person. We have three. Then there's this setup, the Brownie dive system. Very much scalable like we need. It'll hold three divers, no problem. This one is $5,000. $5,000 does not work for us. We do have a budget, but not that high of a budget. We're back to square one. We have to search on YouTube to see if there's anything else. There wasn't. What we did find is we found this.
God damn, this is gonna work.
This is Vogtland Outdoors' answer to surface supply to air.
What a fantastic experiment. This thing works so well. I'm just tickled to death at the idea of being able to go snorkeling 10 feet below the surface of the water for several hours.
Vogtland Outdoors did this thing, and man, he just got us so excited that this is possible. So let's test it. Let's build it. Let's go to Harbor Freight and let's see.
Oh. No, get that one.
There's only one, yeah.
Oh,
jeez.
28 pounds.
If I mean...
No, the whole package is 26 pounds.
I know they say that.
Yeah. Now we got that. We get hoses.
Yes.
We get the splitter.
Okay.
We get the fittings.
Yes.
And that's it.
I mean, we're pretty much done.
Now we need... here, let me... All right, we're gonna need, you're right. All right, I said you were right.
I know I'm right. No, you didn't.
So we need two of those Rapiter chargers. And then we need, these all say three. There's a five. These are newer, dude. Put that one in the package back. Four batteries at $59. Two chargers at $32.99. All the same thing?
Yep.
All right. So we got two chargers, four batteries, three lines, a splitter. I think that's all we need. So prices have gone up a little bit.
A little bit.
We figured with price, we should be around $500.
For everything, literally. Everything. It was like after taxes and a 2-year no questions asked replacement. $640 was that? $640. We're still not even close to a Nemo.
Got it.
Ow. Oh. You need it to damn self.
They don't need to be cut open.
Those.
These smell like Harbor Freight. They always smell like electrical fire.
Did you say something?
That'd be ugly.
Oh yeah. Well,
when you look like this, you're always ugly. $200 in batteries.
That was not my fault.
No, because
you tried to tell him no. Needed the extra batteries though, because it runs off of two.
Oh, I've got it now.
Oh my baby.
He needed the extra two batteries. That way we don't get stuck out.
Damn, that worked. That's awesome. It worked. Right now we're just testing it with a squeeze blower. We're waiting for the regulators to come in from Amazon. And the regulators are only like $26 on Amazon. It's phenomenal to me. Now, whether they work worth the crap or not, I don't know. But right now, as you can see, Jack is swimming in the water with one of our cleaning nozzles. All it does, you press a lever, and it shoots air out the end. And he's doing it. He's breathing underwater. He's doing flips. It's working. And the main thing is, he says it doesn't have a taste to it. It's not weird. I can only imagine what it's going to be like when the regulators come in. Okay, so the regulators are in. Now, me and Jerrid are going to get in with two divers with the regulator and adjust the air pressure. Remember, keep this in mind, folks. I'm an idiot. Only follow my advice if you're an idiot too, okay? I don't take any responsible for what your dumbass does with something that we made. Okay? Okay, just to put that out there. Here it is. Me and Jerrid are in the pool. Both of us, we stayed underwater for 30 minutes, two of us, and the air compressor ran for about 45 minutes. We did a few tests. We tested our purge. We blew up a raft, and then we let the batteries die, and we felt how it feels underwater when the batteries die. Guess what? It works. And what I like about having the tank is 1.6 gallons. What I like about having the tank is there's air in the tank. Once the batteries die, you think about the tank as a reserve tank. So Jerrid and I are getting, I think it's right at 6 breaths each, and it varied. Sometimes we got 6, sometimes we got 5. But 5 or 6 breaths after it dies, now it's a more labored breath. It's not pushing the air into your mouth. You're actually having to take that breath. But it gives you long enough to fix your situation and to get above surface where you don't need it. It's a little cue, because you can't hear it. When you're underwater, you can't hear the air compressor. So you don't know if it's on or off. All you know is how your breaths are. So once it dies, it's a little bit more labored, but you have 4 or 5 breaths left. You just, and the same way. Works great. It works great. We didn't know. There's no taste. There's no heat. After running about 45 minutes, the air compressor, the tank gets kind of warm, but the hoses don't at all. Now, we're only in an 8-foot pool, and we're not down our full 10 foot, but it works, and it works well. So on to further testing. Now it's time to put the family on it. The problem with the family is, so if they like it, we can move to more tests. But if they don't like it, or they get scared, we're done. They'll never touch it again.